Hey guys, welcome back. Today's recipe is a dinner favorite that can easily be made at home. These meatballs are juicy and tender, and the feta and the tomato sauce add so much flavor to this dish. So let's get cooking. I prefer to use chicken mince from the leg of the thigh piece for the meatballs because I find it a lot more juicier and tender. The chicken breast really dries out. So do ask your butcher to use just chicken thigh meat. In that, a handful of fresh coriander leaves chopped. Now these coriander leaves are very aromatic and they also lend an extremely good flavor to the meatballs. Garlic powder gives it the depth or the richness in the dumplings. For spicing it up, I'm going to use paprika powder. It gives again a very nice smoky flavor to the dish and not too spicy. And again an extra herb, which is oregano, which again makes it very aromatic and also flavorful. A generous seasoning with salt, so it brings out the flavors best. And to bind the chicken meatballs, I'm adding a few spoons of breadcrumbs. Now breadcrumbs really help to bind the whole meatballs together. And to give it the extra luxury and the kind of a smooth feel to eat, I'm adding feta. Now feta has been cubed up and added. It mashes up quite well and it mixes very well with the chicken mince. And that's very important because you want the entire mixture to really come together as one. So make sure you mix it well, you break down the feta and you stir in the mixture well. Literally rub it all together, more like kneading it together to bind it. And final thing to add to bind it best is to use a whole egg. This is optional, but I like to use an egg yolk because, or rather an egg, whole egg, because it really binds the chicken mince together. So when you cook the chicken meatballs into a sauce, the egg and the breadcrumbs make sure that it holds the shape well for the chicken mince. Chicken mince is done. It'll rest for a good 10 minutes. In the meantime, let's make the sauce. It's the tomato-based sauce, a very classic way of making a sauce with very, very few things. I always find that when you add less things to a dish or to a sauce, it comes out better. One clove of garlic, finely chopped. One medium-sized red onion, again, very finely chopped. I prefer to use red onion because it has a very subtle flavor. It is intense, but when you cook it, the flavors are released and also it gives a very nice color. If you use white onions, they tend to have more moisture and water and they really don't cook well. And you still find pieces in the sauce and that isn't very appetizing. So for me, for these kind of stews, I always like to use red onion. In a pan, add 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil. I like to use rapeseed oil, but you can use a light olive oil, it works well, or any sunflower oil or peanut oil would also work. Add the chopped garlic into the warm oil. Now oil is at medium heat. You don't want to caramelize the garlic, you don't want to discolor it or make it brown. Just lightly sweat the garlic so that release the flavors into the oil, and then goes in the chopped red onion. Now red onions have to be slightly cooked only. You only have to sweat them very gently so they turn pink. You do not need to discolor them. So the sauce is quite easy and fast to make. But it's just you need to stand around and make sure you stir the vegetables well so that edges don't burn. And that's very important because if you burn the garlic or the onion, it'll discolor the dish. To spice up the dish, a generous tablespoon, rather a teaspoon of paprika powder. Paprika powder has less intensity compared to cayenne pepper or red chili powder. So I prefer to use paprika powder. A couple of cups of tomato passata. You can use fresh tomatoes which have been blitzed into a blender to make a smooth paste, but I prefer to use the canned ones or the tetra pack ones. They work really well. Mix all the things together, add a little salt and heat the sauce on a very low heat just to simmer, just to make sure that all the flavors come together well. In the meantime, let's make the chicken meatballs. And there's a trick behind getting the perfect chicken ball is to actually grease your hand with little oil. Now what this oil does is it makes your hand more like a non-stick. So when you take a handful of chicken mince into your palm, it's shaped quite well. And what you get as a result are very nice, round, smooth, large meatballs. You can make it small meatballs, it's your choice, but I like to have them in a large chunky size so it helps to absorb all the flavors in. So 600 grams of mince and we get 6 large chicken meatballs. Bring the sauce to a simmer, cover it with a lid and let that cook for a good 5 to 6 minutes. What that does is, because you have a lid on, it begins to steam inside. It also gently begins to cook the meatballs right with the steam and with the simmering sauce, and it begins to shape. And it holds shape well because we have added breadcrumb and a whole egg in them. So they are both binding agents. Let it simmer for a good 8 to 10 minutes. And what you would get is that the chicken meatballs are almost done. Turn it around and let them again simmer into the pan with the lid on for 5 to 6 minutes for it to absorb all the flavors. So what you will get is the wonderful rich chicken meatballs. So there you have it, guys. My recipe for chicken meatballs. Serve this with some spaghetti or some rice, and you really can't go wrong. Look at the color. Rich, deep red contrasting with the white. That is really gorgeous. And that's just the way I love to have my food. Bon appétit.